Okay, so we are at the hair store. I have zero idea what I am getting. Zero. I have no idea what I'm getting. I still don't know what I'm getting. So this is a small hair store. So, they don't have a lot of selection. And I'm not seeing anything that I could, I see a lot that I could finesse. But not that I want to finesse. Catch my drift? Yeah, we might have to go to the other one. See, where am I used? So I'm definitely gonna need a cap that can blend in to my skin color. See, this is why I come here. They got way more of a selection than that little ass store. Yo, I just walked out there with exactly what I said I wasn't going to get. Oh, wait. I am back home. Thank God. I'm back home. And I'm going to show you guys everything that I bought. I bought the wig cap that's hopefully my skin color. I bought a little thing of Got2b Ultra Glue because I don't know where my other one is at. I had to go get a can of the free spray, Got2b Glue free spray. Oh yeah, and I also bought this little gel. I bought edge control, this little thing of edge control. The wig. Dun, 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 dun. Never heard of this brand, never heard of nothing. So we are all lost together. And I feel like I'm gonna do these probably like every 2 weeks. This is cute that it has this. Probably every 2 weeks going ahead and do a series like this. Where I just go to the beauty supply store and pick up something and we do a hair project and see if I can finesse it enough to make it look decent. How long is this? Well, I don't know how long it is and I'm short. So like this thing is already like, yeah, let me back up for y'all. It's already like coming to my like hip. And I'm short, so I'm gonna assume this is like a good 22, 24, maybe. I don't even know. I don't know. Don't go based off Mayde because I have no idea. So this is by Mayde Beauty Wig. Yeah, it's called Mayde. And, all right. It says axis symbol rotating cap to the desired part. But to start this series off, I pretty much fucked it up. So if this video comes out like pretty decent and I can finesse good enough, make sure y'all subscribe. So it has some hair instructions. We don't really care about them. But this is in the style Chrystal. Her name's Chrystal. Let's see if I look like a crystal when I put this on. If not, who knows? And it's in the color OP1B30. And yeah, it says curl and iron safe up to 400. I'm not curling it. I'm not curling it. But let's start by braiding my hair.
So
this is the wig stocking cap that I got, and it comes in one size, but I got it in the color natural brown. we will see. Okay. Tucking my braids in. Y'all seen me do this before when I did my stocking wig cap video. If y'all, that method, when I tried that method, if y'all haven't seen it, I'll make sure that I'll put it in the cards. Also down in the description, so make sure y'all check that out. I'm gonna, y'all know, draw my outline of where my hair is. So, I'm gonna spray a little bit. Ooh, ooh, drip, drip. You know, just to secure that. Drip, drip. Ooh. You know, cut to where my, so smart. Okay. Now it's definitely gonna stay. Okay, same thing on the side. Oh, and the same thing comes with two stocking caps. So I always have another one to reuse. Okay, so this looks scary as fuck. All right, so I went on ahead and cut the card off of it. This is what the card looks like. Please do not ask me why I got this. Honestly, I just wanted to finesse and I wanted the long. And this was pretty much everything. Honestly, I've seen all the other wigs. And every color that I tried to get it in or style that I tried to get it in, they were sold out or didn't have the color. So, this is what we settled for. Okay. This is the parting. Y'all see that? Y'all can see, right? It's just a thin strip. I'm gonna try it on her head because I feel like me and her have the same head size. She got a little head, so do I. But it does come with three combs and an adjustable strap so that you can, you know, adjust it. It is big head friendly. Thank God they have adjustable straps because I got a tiny head. So I'm gonna put it on her like this. Oh, I hate wigs. I hate wigs. Oh. So this is what she looks like. I feel like she's gonna be cute. She has potential. She has potential. I feel like she's gonna be cute. She has potential, but we have to do something with this part. And now, mind you, these sides are like nothing. So I'm gonna make baby hairs out of those sides that are nothing. Y'all see me use these all the time. They are non-grip or non-slip, I'm sorry. They're non-slip tweezers. So I use these to pluck hair better. And even though it's synthetic, I'm still gonna spray some water to better grip on the hair and just brush that part down. All right, so I'm gonna sit her like this so that y'all can see better. Plus I'm short, so, and I'm literally just gonna pluck. All right, it looks a little bit better. Let's just say that. So this is what the wig is about to look like when I first initially put it on. Do not judge it. Do not judge it, sis, because it might come out really good. Okay. So. Oh God. Wish me luck. Ugh. I look like turn around and die. I'm pissed. What is this? Okay. So let me just stand up for you guys, show y'all what it's looking like. It comes to my hip. We're gonna fix all of that. These are the main issues that I have with it right now. We're gonna fix this. We're gonna get something on the sides. I need something. I need more. what else am I not really fucking with? Yeah, it's already like matting at the bottom, so I'm just gonna keep the length. I just kind of want to get rid of some of the hair. So I'm gonna go and move upstairs to the bathroom and show y'all how to finesse.
So we gotta start somewhere, sis. And first thing I like to do is start by thinning this out a little bit. Not complaining, it is a very full length. And y'all know when y'all have like weave and shit and it looks so full that it kind of almost makes it look fake, especially for synthetic hair. So yeah, not saying that it's bad, but it's a little thick in some areas. So I'm gonna go on ahead and do that. Let me show you guys the full wig. And this thing is, you can't see it, but it's like right here to my butt. And that's just too much. So hopefully when I thin it out, you know, it's gonna look a lot better. I have these thinning shears from when I was in school and I absolutely love them. I'm gonna actually go section by section because I honestly want this to be pretty decent. I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3. And then when I brush it out, there's already a lot of hair coming out, but I'm gonna brush it out. And boom, it's a little bit thinner. I can feel the difference. Yeah, I'm gonna just do this a couple times. And just let it rock. I'm gonna just keep doing this, and come back to you guys when there's a little bit of a difference. What I like to do is also take it right by the part, like take a section right by the part. Cause usually right up in here is where it's thick. So I'm just gonna go in, out, in, out, and see what that does. See what that does. Now, I've done that before, but I mean, this one wasn't as bad. So you probably can't really tell. Only when I put my head down, you can see how much flatter, or let me move over here. You can see how much flatter it's already gotten from me doing that. This was the excess hair on this wig. Now, the reason why I thinned it out was because it is not gonna get that tangled. It's a lot lighter to work with. It's not heavy, weighing me down, etc. You can not really tell, like, girl, that's not bad. And that was just with a little bit of finesse. So let's keep going. We got still baby hair to do because it looks like a wig on top of my hair. You know what I'm saying? We got to really actually get into it. So I went on ahead and pulled some baby hairs out. Now I'm going to pull the wig up. Two products I'm gonna be using, y'all know, Got2b. I'm using the Got2b glue and the free spray. I'm taking a little bit of Got2b glue because it's synthetic hair, so y'all know we're a little crazy. A little bit of Got2b glue. Oh, this is gonna be hard. And of course I want this to swoop this way, so I'm pouring a little bit on here. I'm gonna pour a little bit on all of them just to lay them down first. So, taking a comb, y'all know, finessing the baby hairs. And I'm not gonna cut anything because quite frankly, I feel like I don't have to. And I'm honestly gonna finesse these back. And this is actually pretty easy because the hair is straight. So, finessing these back like that. I am gonna cut this off. Please do not worry about it right now. For the rest, I'm gonna spray. Okay. This is where the clock starts ticking because this free spray dries pretty fast. So you literally have to pick where you wanna lay and lay. Hold it for a little bit. Pick where you wanna lay. And just lay it. Now, I'm gonna leave it like that Normally, I put my scarf on right now. This will be the time where I put my scarf on. But I got to go do the other side. So I'm going to hurry up and do the other side, come back to show both sides, then put my scarf on because time is ticking, boo. Boom. Shaka-laka, shaka-laka, shaka-laka. This side got to get fixed. Now, I'm going to just take my scarf. I'm so excited to show you guys this video because I just love finessing. Like, at first, if you'd have seen this wig, oh my God. So, I'm going to tie it around like that. Probably leave it on for a good 20, 30 minutes. I'm going to go do a light face. And, yeah. Come back to you guys so I can show y'all the results of me finessing this wig that I bought at the beauty supply store, bitch. So, this is what she looks like. And this is what her sides look like. Now, let me finesse, bitch. This is the end of the first video of my hair project series. This is wig number one. And turn around for the back for you guys. If you guys like this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I'll see y'all in the next one. Also, comment down below some suggestions that y'all will want to see in the next video. But yeah, guys, bye.